Hi, we're here with Bill Kraft with Carolina Mobile Auto Service and my youngest daughter, Mariah. And Bill's going to instruct and show how even an 11-year-old little girl with the proper instruction can change a flat tire. And we certainly have a flat tire right here, don't we, Bill?
Yeah.
But what would be the first thing you would tell a young driver? Now, Mariah's not old enough to drive, but, man, you all of a sudden you notice you got a flat tire. How important is it that you get pulled over?
Well, you got to make sure you're in a place where, first of all, you can change a tire, a flat level surface. You don't want to be on a hill or an incline where the jack can slip out. You want to make sure you're off the road, because a lot of people, cars are close to the road, they're not paying attention to the swerve, and most of your accidents happen when you're along the highway or along the road and someone comes by and clips the car while you're working on it. That's how people get hurt. Okay, first thing you want to do, Mariah, is you want to get your owner's manual out, okay? And it'll tell you exactly in your owner's manual everything you need to do in order to change this tire. The safety precautions, where the tools are, how you put the tools on the car, and everything you need to do to change this tire, okay? So there's your owner's manual. What's the first step it's going to tell us to do? Jacking and tire changing, okay? And it tells you in here, you got to remember, follow the instructions. Make sure you put the jack in right, don't start the engine. First thing we want to do is what? Block both the front and rear of the tire. Now, not the one that you're changing, but you want to do one that you're not changing, because the idea is to not let the car move. So we want to do that. Let's get us a block here real quick. Now, these are what we're going to use for chocking. It's called chocking the tire, okay? We're going to put one in the front of the tire. Put it in the front against the tire. There you go. All the way's tight. There you go. And one behind the back.
Your mercy brake, so grab hold of that and pull up on it. And it'll click and lock. That's right.
Hard as you can.
Okay, good. Now, make sure this is your shifter. Make sure it's in P for park.
Okay, Mariah, here's the tools and the tire we need for changing the tire on this car. This is called a donut spare or a temporary spare, okay? You don't drive long distances on this tire because it's only made for temporary use till you can go get your tire fixed. This is your jack right here, okay? Take your jack, you're going to need that. And this is the lug wrench that you put on the nuts. And this is the pry bar piece for taking the wheel cover off, okay?
Okay.
And all your tools are in here and they're under this cover. They could be in different places in other cars, but they're usually pretty close to the same location in most cars.
Go.
Now that you have the tool to change the tire, what we're going to do is we're going to use this end to take this plastic cover off, because the lug nuts are going to need to loosen underneath that. So you're going to put it like this and pry it off, okay? And you have to go all the way around and loosen it, pry it off, just like that, okay? See if you can do that. Works right there and works back on. Put it in here and push it up like this. Let it do the work. Oh, there we go. Okay, just held on with the spring, so it's not hard to get off. Okay? Now, next thing you got to do is this one holds your wheel on. See these nuts right here?
Mm-hmm.
There's five of them. We want to loosen those, and we're going to use this end of the tool to do that. Okay? Now, counterclockwise. You know how a clock runs. We're going to go the other way. Counterclockwise, loosen. So we want to put this on here like this.
Yep.
Now, Mariah, this is the bar we're going to use, and a lot of women should carry something like this in their car. That'll fit over this tool and it makes it longer. And making it longer, we make it a lot easier to get the nuts loose, okay?
Okay.
Now we're going to take these nuts off before we raise the car up in the air. We want to do that because it makes it easier to take the nuts off. Once you lift it up and try to take nuts off, the tire is just going to spin. It's going to fight you. So we want to do it while it's on the ground. So I'm going to get this ready. And you pull down on that bar and see if you can loosen it.
Pull hard.
Just keep it close to the tire.
Right?
Okay. There you go. Just like that. Do one more. There we go. That was good. Let's go to the next one.
Let's see Mariah do it on her own now, Bill.
Okay, let me get set
after forward. She's practiced on the one now.
You got it. Hold on, Mariah. Let go. Let me get you set up on one that you can get. Okay, that one you should be able to get.
Pull down with all your weight, Mariah. You can do it. You can do it. You're out on the side of the road. There you go. Lean on it just like that.
I'll tell you what, Mariah. You might want to stand up and push on it. Now just be careful, because when it comes loose, it might just going to go to the ground, so don't smash your finger. Push hard.
Put all your weight on it.
Yep, just lean down on it. That's it. All you got.
Yep.
Just like that. Now we're going to come back, we're going to do that one again.
Okay. Now Bill, what we might do in this case, really, is get a longer bar. Because the longer the bar, the more leverage. So let's just stop a second.
We can move it out some.
Oh, move out the bar some.
Okay.
See how that works. Go ahead, Mariah.
There you go.
Oh, you got that one, see? See how that works? The longer the bar is kind of like a seesaw, the more leverage you get.
Okay, push down on that one.
There you go.
Good girl.
Okay. Now, we want to make sure that they're pretty loose, okay? But this will help you all the time. This will always help to loosen that up because the longer it is, the easier
what
it
works
is.
Is this little groove right here? Mm-hmm. There's a little ridge underneath the car here. Okay, see it under there? And that'll fit on top of that just like that. And you use this with your hand until you get it up and snugged against the car. And you're going to take this tool and it fits on that nut just like that. So you do just like that. Okay?
Okay.
Take that and set on the ground for now. And let's find that ridge under there. Look under there and find that ridge.
And Mariah, go ahead and slide the jack right up where the ridge is, right up against it.
Now we got to let it down just a little bit. See, it's a little too high. We put it up against there, and then we tighten it up by hand.
See, it's got to ride right in that groove.
Yep. And we want to make sure that our jack is nice on a firm, flat area. Okay, if you're on a hill or in grass or something like that, you got to be very careful because it can tip over on you. Okay? Now take your jack handle and just start taking it up. Put it on there just like you did the lug nuts. There you go. Now pull towards it. Pull towards it. Yep. See? There it goes. Take it off and then put it on
again. Now you don't. You can just swing the handle. Put it back on right in.
Yep. Put it on. I'll show you. All the way on. There you go. Now pull it towards you. Now once it gets level like this, just watch your leg. But if these cars weigh anywhere from 2,000 to 4,000 pounds, that's why you got to make sure the jack is set right and everything is stable. That's why we set the parking brake, put it in park, and stop the wheels. Next, all you got to do is get it up high. We can get that tire off. Make sure you have enough clearance. And get your new tire on. Okay. The easy way to tell that is by spinning this tire. Looks like we're about clear. See down there? Looks like we'll have enough room. So let's take that handle off. And we're going to finish taking those nuts off.
Leave it straight like that, Mariah, and you can twist them right on off.
Yep.
You want to go counterclockwise. Yep. The opposite way you just put on that.
Just like that. Just like that. All the way off. Now you might be able to turn it with your fingers, Mariah. There you go. Just set that on the ground where you won't lose it. That's it. Set that over to the side. Now look here. I want to show you something on these nuts. This has what's called a conical side, okay? Which means it's got an angle to it. And it's got a flat side. The conical side always goes against the wheel. Because it fits in the hole and makes the wheel snug. The flat side will let your wheel move around. You always got to make sure the conical side goes in. Okay? Keep working on those nuts. Now, if it's a little tight, remember to turn your handle. Okay. Now, put your nut over here and set your tool down. What we're going to do is your hands are going to be sturdy, so don't wipe them on you. Just get a hold of the tire here on each side. Stand up. Hook like that with your fingers and pull that tire straight out. There we go. Perfect. Now, just roll that over out of the way, and I'll get the spare. On the same way, line these holes, these lugs up into these holes. Okay? You have to lift it up and line it up. And I'll help you. Get it from the outside. And I'll help you. Set it up again, sir. And you want to line up those holes. Line up those lugs, okay? How much? There you go. Push it all the way in. Perfect. Now take short lugs. Just leave it like that. Put your two lug nuts. Remember which side goes in. Start threading them on by hand. Yes. That's right. Conical side in. You just start them all by hand first. Good enough.
See, at the end of this, Mariah, you'll be nuts about changing tires.
Now, what we're going to do is we're going to take your tool and we're gonna tighten them so they're snug, okay? But you can't make it too tight, because see how the tire wants to move around? Mm-hmm. So just put it on the nut, lift the handle up towards me, and pull that way more. It's good and snug, okay? Now when we tighten lug nuts, we go across. We're gonna come to here like a star, okay? Mm-hmm. So come here next.
Right, that way you don't warp the wheels, so that's why you go across.
Okay. Makes it nice and even all the way across. Go the other way. Righty tighty, lefty loosey. Okay, if it didn't go far enough.
Never heard that before. Righty tighty, lefty loosey. All right, now. See, you learn all sorts of tidbits.
Okay. You see, we went there, there, there. We're going to go there and then there, like a star. And that, now we have it snug. We want to let it on the ground. Same thing for taking the tire off. We want the weight of the car to keep the tire from moving. So we're going to let it down off the jack, and then we're going to let the weight on this tire, and then we're going to tighten them up.
Go ahead.
Okay.
Now, you go righty-tighty, or do you go lefty-loosey?
Lefty-loosey.
Very good.
That's right. That's right. There you go. Just start taking her down. Pull towards you. There you go. Perfect.
Goes down easier than it comes up, doesn't it,
right? Pull her out of there. There you go. Now, the last thing we want to do is make sure those lug nuts are really tight, okay? So, we're going to go back on with this. Get your helper bar, your cheater bar, okay? Line it on, and pull that way with it. Pull towards the front.
This way or that way?
Yep. Okay, that was good. Let's go to the next one. We're going to start that up. Okay, push down on it. Okay, that's good. Go. It's got air in it, so you're good to go. We want to make sure we put the tire in the trunk, the tools in the trunk, and that won't fit on this wheel. So that goes in the trunk too.
And that's how our 11-year-old and Bill Kraft change a spare tire.